like Graham was saying, if you watch Teddy Reiner does this all day. Teddy Reiner pushes this across, and he waits for them to kind of square out their body a little bit, keep squaring, and then they step back, lose them again. He does that time to time again. So his whole judo is just hop, push across, his whole judo, pacified like this. So good, but he loves just pushing it off, pushing it across all day long. Your partner's like this, and it's their power hand, so they're in big trouble. And I saw you guys doing Sinagi, Harai, Osoto, Owuchi. That's awesome. This setup is for whatever technique you like. That's the cool thing about it. Whatever you want. So the next thing I'm going to show you is a mainly, kind of a light way, it mainly goes towards CLE. But I'll show you anyway because the principle's quite nice. Is I put my jack and I pop this off any way I want. If I grab a normal lapel here, it's really easy for him to grab my grip. Like it's easy. And so that means he's now controlling my power hand, and I don't want that to happen. That's why when I'm doing randori, he's got two grips, I'm shaking. I don't want him to be controlling my power hand. Especially if they're bigger and stronger than me, it's gonna suck. All right, so, and also, I'm not gonna be breaking his power hand by doing this all the time, because I'll probably get a penalty. So I need to do it with keeping a grip. So I don't really want him to have this at all. So a really cool tip I learned is that when you get the sleeve, push across, rather than grabbing the same side with the grab easy peasy. Now when I pivot, when I go to enter, he puts pressure on it, and I can't enter. I'm like, man, that sucks. But then I learned a really cool tip. When I come here, I grab the same side of the belt, but grab it again. He can still grab it. So what I learned is I'll go high. And it's kind of awkward to grab. See how he took two grabs to get it, didn't you? It's kind of like, oh, can't quite get that. So now when I come up with this, and see, even now, we're not randori, and he's like, he's got to grab like, we usually grab like this. And now he's like, you know, grab this thing. So as he goes, yeah, as he's grabbing, my elbow goes to the floor. And it's just my whole weight is snapping down. So we're here, elbow high, snap, 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 snap. And now I'm going to get a response from him, whether it's to coming back this way, in which case you can do Tai Toshi, Sinagis, or if he's going that way, he probably won't look perfect again. Maybe a Diashi, but you probably won't get it. But it's just a really nice way, because I was just finding for ages, I would go, yeah, awesome, and you grab that arm, and my judo would be a bit stuck. So now, elbow high, and you can work on judo. So that time it was a Kiryashi Hara. So when you partner, just go again, but practice the grip break, or not, it doesn't matter. The next step is elbow high. Awkward for him to grip. And when I back step this way, my elbow just goes up and down in a circle. He's stopping the momentum that way, and he's coming back. And as he comes back, I help him that direction. And he can enter for whatever technique you want. You can do a haragoshi for this grip. I think it's called yamarashi, tai toshi, shinagi, whatever you like. But really try to do it from, and you can even do it without this, just from here. Two hands, doesn't matter. But what matters is this elbow is really, really nice. And I'm a groundwork guy, so I kind of don't mind doing a bit of this. Just to drag them to the floor. It's not really a move, but all my weight is on his neck. He has to go down. So have a go with your partner. Still do the same thing, but see if you can find your favorite technique in this sequence, because that's what we want. Have a go.